Do you know how to send an email via SMTP with PHPMailer and Gmail? In today's video, I will talk about PHPMailer class and how to use it to send an email in PHP. We will cover sending a plain text email, HTML email, email with attachment, etc. So, stay with me. Hey, what's up guys? Sinead here from codingpassiveincome.com, the place where I help others to become a web developer much easier and faster than they will do it on their own. So, if that is something that interests you, consider subscribing. Now, for some of you that don't know, PHPMailer is a class library for PHP that provides a collection of functions to build and send email messages. PHPMailer supports several ways of sending email: mail, send mail, cool mail, and direct to SMTP servers. You can use any feature of SMTP based email, multiple recipients, etc. PHPMailer is an efficient way to send an email within PHP. Maybe you can ask now why we will use Gmail for sending mail messages. First of all, it's free, and of course, most website owners can use their own SMTP server for sending email messages from their own websites. But if it makes sense even then to use Gmail for sending mail, the chances is big that your website IP address is on a blacklist if your site is hosted by a shared web hosting provider. Even if that is not the case, there is always a risk that your IP address gets blacklisted. Of course, you can't use SMTP server from Google to send thousands emails per day, but it's a good choice for applications with less than 500 recipients a day. Anyway, let me show you how to actually send an email using PHPMailer class. So now, first thing that we need to do is we need to go to the Google and to download PHPMailer class. So we can use the first result, and here at the right side you have option clone or download. I will just use download zip, and I will choose the folder where I'm going to save it and click on the save. After that, I will go to that folder and I'm going to extract here. I will delete this archive and I'm going to change the name of this folder. I will say PHPMailer. Okay, here I have one folder attachment that and one picture inside, just to show you how to send an email with attachment. And here I have an empty index.php file. So now inside that index.php file, I have just opened PHP tags. So the first thing that we need to do, let's say I'll first write the comments, what are the steps to send an email through SMTP. So first thing is we need to include the class. So that is include phpmailer autoload.php. Create an instance of phpmailer. After that, we need to set a host. Enable SMTP. We need to set authentication to true. Set login details for Gmail account, set type of protection, set a port, set subject, set body, set who is sending an email, set where we are sending email, recipients. And send an email. So first step is require, and you'll see PHPMailer is our folder, and the name of the file is phpmailer.outlook.php. To create a new instance, we need to create one variable mail, new phpmailer. After that, we need to set a host. We will say mail, and we are going to say host, and we are just going to say smtp.gmail.com. We need to enable SMTP, so we'll say mail is SMTP. Now, for this method, on some hostings, it is very important to call this method, but for my personal, which is HostGator at the moment, when I call this method, it basically creates some problems and I'm not able to send through SMTP. So at the moment I will just comment and I won't use it, but it's important for you to know that we need to use it in on some platforms. So we need to set authentication. We'll say set SMTP out equal true. Now mail username, and we need to write here the email that we will use to send an email. So we'll say name seniors at gmail.com, and we need password, mail password equal temp password. Mail SMTP secure, and we will say SSL, or we can use DLC. Port is mail port equal 465 or 587 if DLC. Now the subject will be mail subject test email, body is, this is our body. Now, who is sending an email will say mail set from. Okay, and here we need to write address. We will say that's our basically username, and we will specify the name. Let's say SP. Okay. As you can see here, I have a little like tag address, and here I have a name. This is just a feature by PHP Storm. So if you are using any other ID or text editor, probably you won't be able to see it. So just ignore it for now. I'm using the values in this and this. Okay. Now we need to add some recipients. We'll say add address. And I will say hello at com.com. And now we need to send an email. We'll say we can call the method mail send, and this method will return true or false. So we can use some statement here and say if mail send echo mail is sent, else echo something wrong happened. So let's now try it. I will just quickly upload everything to my web hosting. We can even use this to send from our local host, but I want to show you how to send it from the some shared hosting, which in my case is HostGator. So let's wait a second. So now we have uploaded all files and I'm going to open my browser and I'm going to refresh and I've got response mail is sent. Now let's see, I received the new email. So as you can see, I've got one new email. The subject is test email and the from is SB. So if I click, as you can see, we have here, this is our body. And it's sent by sinebasin@gmail.com. So as you can see, that is working. And that is how to send plain text email. Now I want to show you how to send HTML email. So all we need to do is we need to, I'll do it here, set HTML to true. So mail is HTML and we will just say true. And now inside our body we can use just any HTML tag. So let's say I will say here, let's make two new break lines and let's create one link. Let's say http://google.com. Let's say the link is Google. This is just a quick example. I will upload again. And if we refresh, we got again response mail is sent. As you can see here, I have received one new email. And if I open, as you can see, I have included the link here. So if I click, it will open in the new tab. Now, the last thing that I want to show is how to add some attachment. So we can do it anywhere, let's say here, add attachment. I will say here, mail, add attachment. And here we need to specify the path. So I will go to folder attachment. And I will say the name of the file is facebookcover.png. And here I can specify any name and I will just say facebookcover.png. If we do not include this name, it will just use the name of the file that you are sending. So it's optional. It's on you, will you include the name or not. So I will save it. Going to upload again. I'm going to refresh. Okay. I should receive a new email. Okay, I just got a new email. If I open, as again it's loading the message. We need to download the attachment right now because this client will just open attachment, won't just include it. So okay, as you can see, this is our attachment. It's just shown here and the message is the same. This is our body and this is one link. We can also here, you can see we have one attachment and the name is facebookcover.png. So this is just how to quickly send three different type of emails. The last thing that I want to show is how to enable debugging of sending an email. So if there is some problem, so you can know what is the wrong. So as I already said, if I include this, for some of you will work and for some don't. I will just include and let's see what will happen. Now if I refresh, I just got the message something wrong happened. But the problem is that I don't know what is the wrong. So I will say here, mail SMTP debug equal, and now it's optional to put the number 1 or 2. Usually I use the number 2 to get just a message. And down below here I will say mail error info. So now we will just have the emails what is happening. So refresh, and as you can see now I have complete explanation of what is wrong. So now I can just use and analyze, but I don't need to because I have already did that job and I know what is the wrong. But for you this is very helpful, and also you have a link here where you can see the complete documentation what can be wrong for you. So guys, pretty much that's it. In this tutorial you have learned how to send a plain text email, HTML email, set attachment, and also how to debug if there is anything wrong. So if you like this video, please like it, and also I will really appreciate if you can share with your friends and ask if you have any questions in the comments below. Take care.